Hey guys, welcome again to one of our Ninja Monkeys tutorials. I am Yeknam and next to me sits Ajnin.
Hello. Today we want to talk about data types again. We already talked about the standard data types in TwinCAT 3. But there are a lot more data types, which you can use. They are extensions of the IEC 61131-3 standard, user-defined data types, or both. At first, we want to introduce the subrange data type. This is a data type whose value range only covers a subset of a base type. The base type must be an integer data type. The syntax for this data type looks like this: name, colon, int type, bracket, lower bound, dot, dot, upper bound, bracket. A base type of the subrange can be asint, an usint, an int, an uint, a dint, an udint, a byte, a word, a dword, a lint, an ulint, or a l word. The lower and upper bound of the subrange must be a constant that is compatible with the base data type. Also, upper and lower bound themselves are included in the range. In our project, we have a variable with a subrange. If we assign a value to it, which is not in the range of it, we get an error.
Now we want to talk shortly about the range and LRange checks. These are functions which are monitoring the bounds of subrange data types. They are called check range signed or unsigned and check range L signed or unsigned. Check range signed check subrange types of the type sint, int, and dint. Check range and sign check subrange types of the type byte, word, dword, usint, uint, and udint. Check L range sign check subrange types of the type lint. Check L range and sign check subrange types of the type L word and ulint. The function checks if there are any bound violations. If this is the case, it deals with them. A response to a violation may be setting of an error flag or changing a value. The functions are called implicitly. We will work with our previous example to demonstrate the function. First, we will show you what's happening if we don't use the function. We write baba a, colon, equal, baba b, semicolon. Baba b's value is not in the range of baba a, so what will happen? If we activate our configuration and start it, no error message shows up and baba a takes the value of baba b. That's not what we wanted. To avoid this, we will use the check range signed function. In our project tree, click on POU, add and select POUs for implicit checks. There you find the functions for implicit checks. Select range checks. The window with the function opens. Important. Don't edit the declaration part between var input and end var. Here you have the three input parameters which are transferred to it when the function is called. Value, this is the value to be assigned to the variables of the subrange type. Lower, this is the lower range bound. Upper, this is the upper range bound. Between var and end var. It's okay to add local variables. In the implementation part, you already have a default suggestion. If this works for your purpose, you don't have to change anything. It says that, if the value which should be assigned to the variable of the subrange type is lower than its lower bound, the variable should take the lower bound as value. If the value that should be assigned to it is higher, the variable with the subrange type will take the value of its upper bound. In our case, it will take -2 or 8. If there is no violation, the variable takes the assigned value. If you want, you can change the if instruction. You can define a certain value that is used in response to a violation of a bound. We will use it like it suggested.
We activate the configuration and start our program. Now baba a does not take the value of baba b. Instead, it has the value of its lower bound. or its upper bound, which depends. If the value is higher, it takes the upper bound. If it is lower, it takes the lower bound. If the assigned value is in the range, it takes the value of Baba B. The check signed range function works how it should. Of course, you can change the function if you have other requirements. So that's it for today.
We hope to see you soon in front of your screen. If you want to learn more about TwinCAT 3, watch our other videos and subscribe to our channel. We upload new videos regularly, so hit the bell for not missing them. Have a great day.
Bye.
Bye.